Hey guys, Nick here, and in this video I want to show you how you can utilize Vienna Symphonic Library massive epic Big Bang Orchestra collection of instruments to compose an epic battle sequence music. So without further ado, let's get started right away. Okay, so what do we have here? Pretty straightforward. I always start with my sketching instruments when I start composing. So I have the string ensembles here that are doing the most of the work in this composition. Basically, high strings from lira and low strings from masca, which are doing this sort of like an ostinato riff, as you can see it here. Okay, so, and it's being layered together with a masca doing just the, like, sort of like an accenting, because you want that slightly galloping and jumpy feel when it comes to pretty short stringed articulations, especially in battle music, for video game, for film, whatever. When people usually work on a big epic action music, most composers, especially those who are working in trailers, tend to remove the woodwinds out of the equation. But I think that woodwinds are a very important aspect of a symphony orchestra, because they are like this type of a glue and connection between strings and brass. So I'm always using my woodwinds to support the strings. Basically, they're playing the same riff, the same ostinato as the low strings. So it sounds a little bit warmer in the low end, because once you remove them, it's not there to be heard, it's more there to be, you know, like felt, like an additional color on top of the low strings. Okay, so the way I am bringing more of an impact to this ostinato performance as an additional layer is by adding a full-blown orchestral section, which is Andromeda, the first pack from Big Bang Orchestra. And basically they are playing, what Andromeda is playing is just these long chord progressions here that are being modulated. Basically, I'm just writing the dynamics of the full orchestral section and controlling them with my expression. Here you see I have a big dip here when it in overall volume, because this is where the brass comes in playing the theme. So I didn't want to have the frequencies of the brass and the entire orchestral section clashing and clouding the mix. So this is how the Andromeda sounds by itself.
Thank you.
that's the bulk of the sketching part of this. And then I have horns here, basically playing the melody. Now I started a little bit smaller here, where I have the horns from Jupiter pack, the six French horns from Jupiter, and trumpets from Copernicus. And this is a small sound of, even though six horns are pretty big, but they're quite smaller than the 12 horns from Zodiac that are coming in later on. And now when the main theme jumps in here, I have my 12 horns patch from Zodiac layered here together with the trumpets and just a little bit of the low brass here from, I think it's Hercules. This is where my brass low shorts are playing. Yeah, this is Hercules all the way. So they're sounding pretty clean and mean. And when it comes to giving some more impact to the overall string ostinatos here in the sketching area, as you can see, the Lyra and Masca are carrying the track by themselves and they're doing a fantastic job. But just as an additional layer, in order to have like more presence, I'm using the string packs from BBO, from Big Bang Orchestra, the individual sections, which are Tana, Ursa, Vega, Valia, and Xenia, respectfully. So the Tana are the first violins, Ursa are the second violins, Vega are violas, Valia are celli, and Xenia are the double basses. So it's always important to layer the strings properly so you can have a fuller, thicker sound. And I'm always changing my microphone positions, blending them to get a different sound. So if I have, like if I'm using here for sketching Lyra and Masca, I will have more of the room sound of synchron stage. And for my individual sections here, I will turn down that room just a tiny bit and then have more of a close mic in these sections, just to give a more bite to the room sound. See how they are very much drier sounding than the overall sound of Lyra and Masca. And maybe if I blend them here together, you can hear the sound. See how bigger they sound together? Because Lyra and Masca are giving that big room sound of synchron stage that we all know and love. And then the individual sections here are just giving more presence to this. When it comes to percussion, this is an epic action battle, so it needs to sound a little bit militaristic. So I have my snares here playing their own thing. So it needs to kind of like have that swell and a swell dynamics in its performance, accentuating some notes and everything as the battle progresses, of course. And I have monster hits here from Dorado that are just layered on top of the, I mean, under the snares, just to give it like that more oomph. So it's always following the beat of the strings, and now when you add toms here, it sounds even bigger. And if you put some strings there, you get a really, really, that the building blocks, the basics of a battle scene, like rhythmical string ostinatos and marching percussion. That's the sound. And of course, for the mallets and for the pitch percussion, you always gotta have some timpani here to accentuate especially this build-up. That's basically it. That's how you can create an epic battle scene music with just Vienna Symphonic Library's Big Bang Orchestra. My name is Nick, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!